He hath perfected forever them settled matter. Whether you will go to heaven is not a prayer point. After this life, let's pray that we make it. Shut up, I made it. I made it. We're not going to make it. Heaven is not a race. It's a place. When I received Christ, I sat there. Woo! He said, what about the foundation? Hey, what about the foundation? You know, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? Some of you come from family where your father was a native doctor, your mother was a native mama, and your sisters were all shrines. And you know, sometimes when you come from those families, you know, all the firstborns, they don't do well. It's a family threat, circumstantial message. When they start preaching like that, tell them, for no other foundation can any man lay than that which is laid. On Christ, the solid rock, I stand. All other ground, who am I talking to here? God punish the devil and his mother-in-law. Somebody shout, saved, sanctified, justified, once and for all. Sanctified how many times? Saved how many times? Justified how many times? Accepted how many times? He said, you know, you have to fast and pray so that God can accept you. It's another done. You're not accepted because of what you do. You are accepted because of what he has done. Oh, glory to God. Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love. Through the storms, he is Lord, Lord of all. Glory to God. Woo! Ele Badona. In 2 Corinthians 6:18, he doesn't want you to come to him. He came to you. Read for me.
And will be a father unto you, and ye shall be my sons and daughters, saith the Lord Almighty.
I will be a father. You will be my sons and my daughters. Read verse 17 for me.
Wherefore come out from among them, and be ye separate, saith the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you.
Yes.
And will be a father unto you.
Yes.
And ye shall be my sons and daughters, saith the Lord Almighty.
This is not Paul's imagination. What Paul was saying here is what he took from Ezekiel. Is what he took from Jeremiah and interpreted it in the present light of the finished work of Christ, which has been God's mind from the beginning of time. So the Pauline epistles were not Paul's concoctions. No, it was just insight given to Paul in the scriptures. He took the scriptures in the light of Christ and put them together to form our family album. That's the teachings of Brother Paul. It's a revelation of Jesus Christ given to him for the church. It's our spiritual diet. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. That's the promise of scripture. Look at God asking for a house in Isaiah 66 verse 1 in the prophecy.
Thus saith the Lord, the heaven is my throne and the earth is my footstool. Where is the house that ye build unto me?
So heaven is not God's house. Earth is not God's house. Because after he said heaven is my throne, earth is my footstool, he now asks, where is the house? Read on.
And where is the place of my rest?
I have not found a resting place. Heaven is not comfortable. Earth is not comfortable. I need a house. I need a place of rest. This is God talking. You want to ask God, you mean after the temple of Solomon, with all the billions spent, God said, no, it's not comfortable. What about the temple of Moses? Not comfortable. What about the temple of Zerubbabel? God said, I even told Zerubbabel, this one that you are trying to build a temple for me, the temple I'm looking for is not by might, it's not by power, it will be built by my spirit. I'm looking for a house. Where is my house? Since nobody could provide that house, all of us resources could not provide that house, God became a man. And when he became a man, he said, destroy this temple. And in 3 days, we will build a temple that God can live inside. We will build a house that God can rest inside. And when you got born again today, your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost. He lives in you. You are the resting place of God. God is resting inside. I feel like preaching. If you feel what I feel, jump on your feet and get serious. Get serious, get serious. You are not serious in this. Get serious. You are the house of God. You are the resting place. Heaven can't contain him. Earth can't contain him. But Abel contains him. Abel carries God. I live in them. I walk in them. I will be their God. They will be my sons and daughters. We don't have the power of attorney. We have him. The totality of God lives in me. When I walk, all of God is walking. And when I say it cannot happen, heaven says it cannot happen. Shatolamananga. As your amen will come like thunder, every attack of the enemy planned against you is aborted from plan. Yeah.